Hello, everybody, and welcome back to VTuber Tabletop. We really need to record our pre-stream chats.
Whoa. Yes, we do.
Say hi, everybody. Oh my
Hi.
Hello, everyone.
Whoa.
Oh my lord. Oh my gosh, why is. I just. Oh my lord. Sorry, roll 20. The. There we are. Let me extend this out.
That gap is so sad.
There we are. Welcome back, everybody. Couple of announcements. First of all, there is no Pastel tonight. Unfortunately, she's not feeling very well, so hopefully she'll be back for next week, and if not, you'll see her back in January after our Christmas break. Third announcement, we have Yuri's and Nightbot commands. Woo!
What? We do? Oh
You do.
my gosh! Holy shit!
It's official, baby!
So, feel free to spam those. What else? What other announcements?
The emotes?
We have new emotes, everybody. We have a Amish Radical emote. We have a Matisse card.
Oh.
Which is awesome. We came up with those. Astrid was under the pump trying to get the Amish one out just
Totally did
before.
not just take me like 10 minutes.
No, it totally didn't take a 10 minutes.
No.
Any other announcements? Episode 2 of Guardians will be live next or tomorrow, technically. There's time zones. Tomorrow at 9 p.m. EST, 2 a.m. GMT, and 10 a.m. Australian Western Standard Time. Apart from that, I don't think we have any announcements today, so I think we should get right into it. So, go to the recap. The
You
recap
skipped
of.
the whole plugging thing.
Oh,
I
fuck me! It's
had
time to
the
hash.
emotes ready too.
Oh my god, it's time to hashtag plug yourself. I thought, oh my god, that took too short of a time. I skipped everybody's favorite part of the episode. I'm such.
What is wrong with you?
You may. Do you want my position as Dungeon Master?
Ooh.
No, you're not having it. So let's start off. Everybody's favorite time of the day. You may kick us off. Hashtag plug yourself.
Yes, hello everyone. My name is Usubeni Yume, the Rebel Poet of VTT. You can find my content under my YouTube channel under the same name. Pretty soon, I don't know when, but I'll be releasing a Lucy origin story, like a short story that you guys will be able to see. Following his life before he became a soldier and a little bit during that time when he was actually a soldier. So if you guys like Lucy and want to learn more about him, please look forward to
Oh boy, do I want more?
Cool.
Do I want more stuff to hold against you?
That.
Oh
Alrighty, Astrid the Arcana.
Oh shit.
Did you just take a
Sorry.
bite of something?
Ice cream, yeah.
Ice
Sorry. That's a perfect way to introduce myself. Good first impression. Hi, I'm Astrid, and I play games and do art here on Twitch. I've been on a bit of a Fallout 4 streak because I'm very close to finishing the main story. My first time playing, so very hype. I also like Skyrim and a bunch of other stuff, and I do art over on my Twitter and sometimes on Instagram, which I haven't posted on in a while, at Astrid Arcana. And yeah, I am very, very psyched for tonight. And I will continue to eat my ice cream very quietly in the background. Thank you.
Amazing. Mr. Vossler.
Well, yes. I'm Winton Vossler, a detective VTuber and part-time cat boy. I'm a variety gamer, and I just play a bunch of games and stream them and try and have fun doing it. I finished Kingdom Hearts 2 yesterday, so
Ooh.
I don't know what I'll be doing. Like, my life is a void now. Thank you very much.
Yuriza.
Hi, I'm Riza. I also do art and gaming here on Twitch. And I do not I was looking for witty one-liners all day, today, and yesterday, and I couldn't come up with any of them, so expect nothing. Thank you.
You have those quotes, don't you?
I do, but I can't say those on this stream. Is this stream 18 plus?
Sure. It basically is at this point. I'm only kidding myself. It should be. Yeah, it really should be. How do I make it 18 plus? How do I go to...
Channel settings, mature audiences.
Channel settings. Where are those?
I think it's if you...
I have to go into Twitch.
Yes.
All right. Twitch. Let me plug myself. Hello, everybody. I'm Melon the Magister, humble dungeon wizard. I am affiliated officially. Yeehaw.
Yay!
Hell
yeehaw.
Yeah.
I basically play Apex. That's all I do. So join me if you like Apex Legends. I am the world's most mediocre Valkyrie. Although, I've had some pretty lit games recently. So if you want to see maybe me... If you want to watch me maybe not be shit, consider giving me a follow. So, let's make a stream. Mature content enabled. Oh, alright guys, yeah. We're now 18 plus.
Yes! Hell yeah. Fuck! Shit! Pussy! Sorry. Like I wasn't like this before.
Yeah, as if I dropped the C-bomb a couple times. Anyways.
Oh wait, oh my god, I called Cinderash. I called yes, her a cunt.
You did.
Holy shit. I went insane. Okay, wow. Mmm.
So,
yeah, family show, haha.
Without further ado, with this extremely scuffed intro, I'm gonna recap episode 20, Rowan. Arriving at the new location of Xandros' headquarters. The group make an appointment with the elusive yet powerful orc. Down a spiral staircase located underground, the group encounters Andros, and Lucy tries to question him on the location of Eve. However, neither are set to budge until Lucy teaches at the location of the secret bardic instrument. Too busy profiting off the world burning, Xandros sets his trap, revealing the individual to just be an elusive. Once again, Lucy himself is imprisoned while the others contemplate their next move with or without Lucy. Using Dante's sending spell to communicate with Lucy, the group are able to guess that Lucy is busy causing trouble and already figuring a way out of jail. Unsurprising, their guess is correct, as Lucy partners with the tiefling Rowan and an old friend Armesh to break out of prison. With Rowan's strength, they are able to escape their cells and disguise themselves as prisoners and guard. Rowan, Armesh, and Lucy act their way out of the prison, well-timed spells, and cute bluffs to their advantage. Woo! While waiting at Emmeth's new house... Ooh, gosh. Thank you, Windows Security. While waiting at Emmeth's new house, Emmeth, Matif, and Dante receive a note from Gustin, alerting them that they are aware of the situation and must leave the city as soon as possible. Eventually, Rowan, Armesh, and Lucy find their way back to Emmeth's house after being instructed by Dante. After awkward introduction and uneasy handshakes, the group and Rowan take a long rest in the large house. However, Lucy pulls Rowan outside during the night and tests her unknown intentions. Rowan, not knowing her purpose or direction, strikes a resonant chord with Lucy. The two shake hands towards an amicable and trustworthy relationship seemingly destined by fate. Rowan then, as she falls asleep in the late hours of the evening, strange visions of a land far off and a woman never seen. So, you all awaken from your long rest in the house of Emmeth's once mother, now demon matron? Question mark. What would you guys like to do?
So, is Armesh still here?
Radical! Yeah, plus he's still here.
Is he still asleep?
He's surprisingly one of the first people to awaken.
Oh. Well, considering we haven't seen each other since then, I think Lucy's gonna walk up to him and say, Amesh, how's it been, buddy?
Right as I put a mint in my mouth, you say you walk up to Amesh.
What's up, bro?
Yeah, long time no see.
Yeah, man.
What you been doing?
Dude, this, like, 2 weeks since I last saw you has been fucking wild.
Really?
Yeah, man.
Tell me about it a little bit.
Yeah, so I met this dude, right? And he said, look, I got this, like, little section of dragon grass. Just follow me. And I followed him for fucking, like, 500 miles right down the coast. And I was like, where is this freaking dragon grass, man? I've been following you for, like, 500 miles. Too far. And he turns to me with this fucking gun, and he puts it to my head, and he says, give me all your money, and I tell him, I don't have any fucking money. So I beat his ass, and I went for a swim, and I, like, started, like, swimming, and then I woke up, and I was here, and I was like, fucking radical. Cool new place. Oh, sick. So I, like, started walking, started smoking some of my... Yeah. Wheat dragon grass, and I got arrested. Crazy.
This man that you beat up, is he anyone of importance?
Nope. Not anymore. Nice.
All right, well, seems like you've been making full use of your new freedom. With me, nothing much, I guess. Just ended up dying, you know?
You see his eyes go from, like, his normally, like, usually his eyes are half closed, but you see his eyes widen, and you get to see his, like, the full display of his reptilian-looking eyes. He looks at it and he's like, bruh, that's heavy.
Yeah, it's a long story, but essentially I died, came back, not even really sure what I am anymore, but here I am.
Dude,
alive?
Same.
Yeah.
I feel that.
How's it with you and your magic? Anything come back to you?
Nah, man. If I could do magic, I'd be, like, famous or something.
It's, nice to have you back, and glad you're here.
Nice, yeah. Nice to see you.
And then we'll wait for the rest of the party to wake up and...
oh my lord. I'd say, Rowan, you probably roused by this point because you fell asleep on the couch. So you're you're hearing this whole conversation between Lucy and Amesh.
I wanted to ask if I was there.
yeah, you're there. You're lying on the couch.
Pretending to be asleep, huh?
I poke my head up. Wait, you came back from the dead?
I did. You want to hear about it?
Absolutely I do.
If you would like to hear about it, please watch episode 16 of
Heralds. Oh my god!
I believe it's episode 16, did I get that right?
Yes,
I believe it is.
Yes.
Episode 16.
Mm, yes it is! Yeah. Nice plug.
Oh my god.
Yeah, well, might as well tell the story since my friend Amesh and you haven't heard it, so. Long story short, a mind flayer came to terrorize the town. And he ended up taking my mind. And then dear old Lim brought me back using a wish. And I grabbed both of their hands and put it on my chest. As you can see, my body isn't what it used to be.
When you put your hand...
You feel like a...
Yeah, yeah. You continue, man.
I was just going to say the same thing you're going to say.
Yeah.
Where when they put their hands on, it's just a very slow, irregular heartbeat.
Every maybe like 15 seconds or so, there's a single beat.
Oh my god.
Well, that is not vibing, bro.
May I use a divine sense to detect evil and good as we touch him?
Let me look up divine sense real quick. I need to look at the wording of these things. Sometimes juicy details. Divine sense.
Please don't kill me.
Lucy, can you send me your alignment, please? Privately.
Okay.
Whoa. Chaotic evil.
Okay. So you can sense that he is good.
Mm-hmm.
So you get the, like, a smell of, like, peppermint, like a sweet, like, tangy kind of smell.
Mm-hmm.
Although you do detect that he is undead, but it's not, like, powerfully undead, only slightly.
Okay, that is exactly what I wanted to know, whether he was undead or not, since he is back from the dead. And I turn to Lucy, and you are aware that you are undead, right?
To some degree, but I'm not really sure what that means for me. Have you come across many others like me?
I would tell you if I remembered. I subconsciously turn my sword away from him because it does a lot of radiant damage. maybe you shouldn't touch my sword is all I'm gonna... Please don't touch any of my stuff. Some of it might be harmful to you.
On a second note, on your divine sense, when you look over at, let's say at this point, Dante, you come walking down the stairs, you sense a very subtle, like, very similar to Lucy, how he's undead, but only, like, very slightly. There's only, like, a slight slightness to it. You sense a slight celestial energy coming from Dante.
Mm.
Sorry, I'm taking notes.
Oh, no, that's fine.
All right. Before I turn to Dante, I was wondering, is the gem still in Lucy's chest?
It is. Oh. On
Do
a third
sense
note.
Anything?
Oh my god.
Oh my god, so many things. you sense a slight fiendish energy coming from the...
Gotcha.
My god, so many... My god.
Wait, fiendish? Okay.
So what's the diagnosis, Doctor?
I am a little embarrassed because I didn't notice that I was kind of focusing on all the stuff I'm feeling. Well, I'm sorry for just, checking. I just wanted to, I'm sorry, it's automatic. I sense that, first of all, you are at least slight to a part undead. I also sense a fiendish presence from that gem in your chest. Who did that to you?
Have you ever heard of a wish dragon?
No. Oh, I am connecting the dots between coming back to life and am using a wish.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's just say I sold my soul to the devil. And here's the price that I have to pay.
Feels like a devil, all right. Do you have any way out of this?
Who knows? Obviously, death isn't the way out. there are some things that I've been asked to do, but I'm working on it. Is there anything, considering you seem to be a little bit knowledgeable about this, is there anything that can be done about my situation?
The undead situation or the wish dragon situation?
The undead situation. Let's start small.
I don't know. I would have to maybe go into a library and read up on some stuff about this. Or get my memory back some other way. I'm not entirely sure, but I'm sure there is something we can do. I hope.
Yeah, I guess we'll see, right?
Yeah. Can I get distracted by feeling the celestial aura of Dante behind me? And I see we have an angel here? Well, a tiny angel. Slight. I'm getting some slight angel vibes here. Oh, that is Dante, correct? And I'm looking at Dante directly, like I'm kind of trying to talk to him.
Yeah. And while responding, he's also going to look around like, an angel? Where?
Who?
Good morning.
Good morning. May I ask, if it's not too rude, what are you?
That's a strange question. I'm a halfling. Born and raised in Markovia. I don't think there's more to it than that. Lived there until recently. Now I'm on the road with my friends.
I see. Interesting. So a wooden halfling from Markovia with a celestial aura about him.
Celestial aura? What's that about? Do I have a celestial aura?
Yes, you do. It's not very powerful, but it's definitely there. Can I take a closer look and see if it's maybe coming from the antlers or the skin or anything like that that might emanate it?
How long does it last for?
Only one action.
One action. You can do it again.
I want to try again.
Sure. Okay. So, there is a celestial aura coming from Dante himself.
Oh.
There is a celestial aura coming from his antlers. And there is a celestial aura coming from his staff as well.
Okay.
Notably, there is a particularly strong divine aura coming from his staff.
Okay, this staff, where did you get it from? I approach him and kind of take a closer look at the staff.
Merlin, where did I get it from?
It was a reward for completing something, I believe. I believe we got it after the wine. Yes.
Yeah.
It was a gift from Mario.
Got it. We helped out this wine maker in Markovia, and he gave us this stuff. And it just, it works really well for me. So yeah, I enjoy it. Does the stuff have anything to do with the whole celestial thing?
Yes, it does. It is quite remarkable that a wine trader from Markovia would be in possession of a celestial staff.
Funny story and to that, actually.
What's the story to that? You guys have gone through a lot, haven't you?
Yes, we have.
You want to tell the story, Dante?
You know what? I think it's better you do it.
Alright. Well, essentially, the man we met, Mario, he wasn't what he seemed. He was actually a very old, maybe celestial being. He's been around for quite a bit, and I don't really know much more than that other than he revealed himself to us.
All right, yeah, that does explain it. That does explain it.
There's a lot to catch up on in this group.
There is. I'm starting to notice, but I'm happy to fill my brain with something.
Yeah, well, we've all got empty heads here. And is Emmett around yet?
Probably after you say that line about having empty heads. I'm probably just in the stairwell. Morning.
And then?
Morning.
Good morning.
Really nice house you got here.
Thanks. Inherited it myself, I guess.
Any sign of Matif? Not... He isn't sick again, is he?
I'm not sure. I'll go check on him. I'll be back in a second.
Okay. I'll go check on Matif.
For the sake of me not having to roleplay Matif. As another NPC. Matif comes down and he joins the group. He's just hanging out.
Cool. He's just vibing today.
He's just vibing. Yeah.
Pot of vibe.
Remember, I got my photo reward.
Yes.
No, were you going to say something, Rowan?
I don't believe so.
Well, as y'all know, we are in a bit of a pickle. We need to find our way out of the city and at least get out of here somewhere.
Very much true.
Are we still keen on using Del Noah's ship?
Matif will be very much against that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the ship that murdered his crew. So, probably he would not be happy.
Oh. All right, well. Any other ideas or connections we can use?
Where's Gustin at the moment?
He left you the note saying, get the fuck out of Dodge.
Yeah.
He was busy doing stuff.
Where were we heading?
Well, that's up to you guys, because you guys have a lot of stuff you guys can do going east. No, west. I know directions. Okay, so Gustin... So just to recap, so everybody's on the same page. Gustin said that he thinks the third instrument is in Bellissima, which is way to the west. Lucy, a part of your contract is you have to find... I haven't kept my notes, my lord. I actually don't know what I said. What were the jobs you had to complete for Sundaresh? Can you remind me, please?
Yes. So one of them is I have to kill a mage.
Yes.
There's another one. Sorry, there's three things I have to do.
Yes. You have to kill a mage by the name of Intan Lahan.
There's two other things. I don't have the names down.
Oh, she didn't give you names. So I believe she said you had to find a mountain. See, this is the thing about... I don't keep very accurate notes on... There is my book. Sorry, guys, give me 1 second. I need to try and find my notes.
And, Rowan, is there any place you gotta be?
Huh. I actually wanted to ask if I were to want to tag along with this group, would that be acceptable to all of you?
I look toward the group and see what their answer is. Sorry. Go ahead.
because as it stands right now, I have no direction to go. And while you guys cannot trust me, you can trust my strength and that I can protect you until I know what the hell I'm supposed to do here.
Do you have somewhere else best to be?
Maybe, but right now I do not remember that.
Can you kill things?
I have the ability to, yes.
You know what? That's good enough for me. Look, if you backstab us, I'll be the first one to cut your head off, alright?
That does sound fair, yes.
Yeah. It's fair. I believe it's fair. Well, I'm fine. What about you, Dante?
It's probably fine, right? Having more people with us would probably make things safer.
So that's a yes in Dante language.
Yeah.
Good.
Well, dudes, I'm sorry to have to be the bummer here, but I've actually got to meet a guy in Ville-Sucre.
Oh.
Yeah, I've got like a business idea to go start like a dragon grass farm.
Oh my god.
And I met this guy who knows a dude who might be able to set me up. So like, I've got a Gucci out of here, but it was nice seeing you all.
It was wonderful to see you, Amesh. It was a pleasant surprise.
Yep, don't forget about us, buddy.
You know, I'll only forget about you when I black out drunk. At all other times, you're at the front of my mind.
Good to know.
Have it any other way.
Try not to get arrested.
no promises at all.
That's... yep.
I owe 500,000 in fines. Rowan, it was nice meeting you.
It was nice meeting you, Amesh. I have, and I can say that with confidence, never met a person like you in my life before.
Same! Gives you a bro fist.
A bro fist back.
Oh, you're strong. Radical.
I'm sorry about that.
If you ever want a good time, and he hands you a little bag, just hit this up, dude. It's like the best quality you've ever seen.
I will take this contraband and consider carefully what to do with it. Thank you.
Oh, radical. See you, dudes. And he just walks out the door.
Amish so much.
I love him.
We have a radical emote also, everybody.
Best boy.
Radical!
Easy come, easy go, that man.
He sure is.
Yeah, sure is something.
Yeah, so it doesn't seem like there's any immediate rejections to your plea, so yeah, feel free to tag along, Rowan.
Thank you. I will be your shield until we decide otherwise.
Well, that other means of business, how are we getting out of here, if not by a ship?
Sorry, real quick. I think I've figured out one of the things you needed to do. Also, Emeth, what is your deal with Sundaresh? Can you please remind me?
I need to take a piece of whatever Dante's looking for.
Yes, okay, cool. Thank you.
I don't know if I got the name.
No, you didn't.
Oh, wait. No, I might have.
No, you didn't.
Oh. I didn't.
Okay. You have to visit two mountains, Lucy. Visit two individuals. One is in the north of Jorin. I'm going to have to go back to the VOD and check which one it is. It's either under the mountain Yorn or Thane. It's one of the two. I can't remember. I have a feeling it's Yorin, but I can't remember. And the other one is you have to journey to the mountain at the center of Tanin Likar. I'm pretty sure that's the right island. I might be wrong. It might be the other island. Pretty sure it's the mountain at the center of Tanin Likar. That is cool. Off the top of my head what I believe it is. I'm going to go back and watch the VOD just to make sure. But either way, we know the general direction you're heading.
All right.
Dante, you know where you're headed.
Hmm?
Yeah. Dante, you know where you want to go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know where I want to go.
Jail.
Which is somehow the same direction.
What the fuck?
Whoa. What? An interactive world where all of your, like, quests, like, are roughly in the same area? Wow. Who would have thought?
Wow. That's so convenient, isn't it?
Convenient.
It's almost like it was planned out that way.
Almost, except I don't plan.
Sure, actually. Well, I want to head to Pintika, so.
So, Em, I got a question for you, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Would you happen to have any connections to individuals that might be able to get us out of here? Of the seafaring type?
Now that you mention it, Marilyn, is Mimum's crew in town?
Well, she is semi-retired, but there is a chance they're in town.
Do I know the crew, and are they in town?
you would know.
I would have worked with them and shit, right?
Make a investigation.
Six.
Give me that because no, I don't want that. Background. I'm just looking up the pirate background. Give me. I don't give a damn about your reputation. Okay. So. You know some people. Even with a six, you know people. You don't even need to. You literally have a feature called Ship's Passage.
Well, there you go.
So.
I may know a few people. People that I've, sailed with before.
All right. Is that something you're willing to do?
Yeah, I think so. And yeah, I should be fine. Yeah. I don't think anyone hates me, right?
Well, sorry, Dante and I couldn't be more help. We are from Markovia, after all, so.
Oh, no, it's fine. Well, Emeth would know where to start, Astrid doesn't.
In regards
to finding said crew.
Sure,
or
so.
Pete.
Now, the question is, are you going alone or are you taking your crew? Because currently, all of you, except for Rowan, are kind of wanted. So Lucy is like public enemy number one. The rest of you are under investigation, except for Ron.
Yeah.
So are you guys traveling as a group or are you going alone?
No, definitely not in that case. I think I should be the only one to go. It's much too dangerous if, well, any of us, except for Rowan, leave here, just out in the open.
Yeah. Well, maybe, Go ahead.
I'm sorry. I just wanted to... Should I come with you? In case things go south?
True, now that I think about it, unless you've committed some terrible war crime that you or we are not aware of. No, I don't really see too much of a threat if you decided to come along.
Good, good. All I've done so far is better an innocent man, so that should be fine.
That's nothing. That's like common ground here. Don't worry about it.
Okay, I'll try. It's been kind of on my mind since yesterday.
Ah, I see. Well, yeah, maybe... Yeah, maybe we can, you know, get to chat. I don't really... Still don't know who you are, only just met you near hours ago, yesterday evening, and... Yeah. Might be nice for the both of us.
Yeah, it would be nice to talk to you a little bit.
Yeah. Well, in that case, the rest of you guys, I suppose, whilst we're gone, just grab as much shit as you can. You know, food, any supplies you can find, really. And be prepared to leave on a whim.
You guys know around what time you'll be back?
I suppose... Depending on how far we have to, you know, walk there and back. Or run. Hopefully not. Be ready. Gonna say, maybe within... a couple hours? An hour, if we're good. If things go well, an hour.
Dante, you got a way to, use that book of yours to contact them?
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Emma, if you could just come over here real quick, yes.
Sure.
And I'm just
what have you got?
Going to the back page of my book, and like saying, if you could just write your name on this page. Then I could contact you like I did with Lucy.
Oh, it sounds quite fancy now, doesn't it?
It's really cool. Yeah.
Hmm. All right. Then I'll write my name. Okay. Now what?
Now it should just work. So I'll just write like a test message going.
Now it should just work.
Can you hear me?
You hear Dante's voice in your head saying, "Can you hear me?"
Can I respond to my head then?
Yeah.
I guess Dante. Oh, does Dante hear it or does it come back onto the page?
It comes back onto the page.
It comes back onto the page.
Ah, you'll see the words loud and clear come onto the page.
Just. Cool.
Neat.
Yeah.
It's very
now
handy.
We can contact
actually.
Each other.
Hmm. All right.
I watch a little bit enchanted because this is amazing.
Well, be safe, you two.
We will. I hope, at least. Yeah. Be ready.
Yeah.
You guys be safe as well.
Thank you. Dante, we'll try to check up on you guys every 30 minutes or so.
Sure. Well, how long is it actually going to take? I just thought of a time straight up. I don't know how far I have to walk or anything.
So your mom's house is literally right near the docks. So it's only like a 10-minute walk to the docks.
It might not be... It'll be like under an hour then, I'd say. Or an hour.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's head out.
I pick up my weapon and would like to just automatically take up the space behind to the left of M.
Mm-hmm.
As if I've just done that a lot.
Sure.
I'll make sure to pull my hood that is totally on my cloak over, or if I don't have a hooded cloak, I'll, you know, grab a hooded cloak and put that over my head instead of my hat and stuff.
Oh.
Yeah. And we head towards the docks, I guess.
You head towards the docks, to the dockmaster's hut, which is this small wooden building that overlooks the entire dock. It's on like a sort of raised platform. There's a set of stairs that kind of goes around the hut so you can reach the door and talk to the person inside. You get to him and knock knock onto the door. And you see a very overweight human man with a scraggly beard. He's bald. He's got a big old scar right across his forehead, as if it's like horizontally been cut. And he's kind of like wearing like this big wife beater, this white singlet top, and these like black shorts. He looks really unkempt. Looks like you're, hey, what you want?
Looking for a couple of friends.
Oh, ain't you don't know his girl?
I'm sorry?
Ain't you don't know his girl?
Oh! Yeah. Yes. Yes.
That's one too many yeses, but I'll take your word.
Yes. I just became Dante for a hot second.
Hey, what you want, man? What you want?
I'm looking for insert name here.
Just say I'm looking for somebody to.
I'm looking for. I thought I was looking for specific people that like I'd used to sail with. And stuff.
You find Don okay. Gilnell so the wording cringed. Of sailor slash pirate is. Ship's passage. When you need to, you can secure free passage on a sailing ship for yourself and adventuring companion. Might be a ship you've served on or another ship you have good relations. I'm interpreting that as because your mother was so well known in the sailing and pirate community that you can get a ship passage on just about any ship you want.
Yeah. I'm just like equivalent of like the rich kid.
Yeah.
That has connections sure. Because their parents are rich. I'm looking for a couple of people that could help run a ship, which I think I'm in the right place, no?
Yeah, well, you'd think so. Which way are you heading?
Which way are we heading again? I don't know which west. General direction we're heading.
I think it was west.
We're heading west.
Yeah, if you want to head down there, talk to Leaf.
Leaf.
Hey, yo, that's his name.
Okay.
And he points down to this small little ship, maybe, like, it could fit. It looks kind of like a Viking longship. A little bit.
Ah. Lovely. Thank you.
Hey, there's no problem.
Alright, I guess we'll walk there?
Sure. You walk down the dock and make your way over to this Viking longship kind of looking boat. You can see that there is an older elvish man. He's relatively slim. He's very sun-kissed. He's got white tanned, leathery skin. Very handsome, though. He's got this white... long white hair, almost, what's the name? Legolas type hair. Looks very elegant, but you kind of met with this very well-worn exterior. Like, the hair almost doesn't match his current profession. Yeah, you walk over to this man, and he turns to you.
Oh yeah, hello. How can I help you?
Yes, I'm looking for Leaf.
Yeah, you would have found him. I help you.
Ah, hello, Leaf. I'm looking for a couple people to help. We need to sail west, me and a few of my
Well, ain't you lucky? That is the direction we are going.
Oh, that's brilliant, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Lovely. So when are you planning to leave off?
He looks down at his wrist, and you see that he's not wearing a watch. He's just looking at his wrist.
Okay.
Yeah, it would be later this afternoon.
Later this afternoon. Tengold says that you make it within a couple hours.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay, cool. I'll toss some Tengold.
Cool. Oh, thank you very much. I will see you soon.
No worries. See you and, well, as soon as possible, if that's alright.
Yeah, not a problem.
Alright, thank you.
I apologize to all of our German and German-speaking viewers for butchering that accent.
Joy to listen to.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, hello. The only German accent I know how to do. So it is every single elf you ever meet.
I do not apologize. Sorry.
Oh, my God. I guess I'll take the time to chat to Rowan on our way back.
I bow to Leaf. Or how do you say it? Leaf?
Yeah, Leaf.
Leaf, okay.
Just like a leaf, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll just get this out of the way. They have Swedish naming conventions, but they speak like Germans.
Oh my god.
Welcome to the fun, wacky world of Iruvia.
I love it.
Yep.
Okay, I just quickly bow to him before I follow Emeth further.
Oh yeah, I like that one, as you walk away.
Oh, being very formal there, aren't we?
Oh, do you not do that here?
No. No, we don't, actually.
Oops. Alright.
It's fine. It's not a very common thing. Usually you just kind of, tip your head to say thank you. Or, you know, sometimes it's a punch in the face. It really, really does depend on the situation.
I see.
Yeah.
I'm taking that 100% seriously. Like, there's no... This is incredibly important information to me. Then I would like to turn to Emeth and kind of tilt my head. I wanted to thank you for accepting me into your home, even though you had no idea who I was. I wouldn't have known where to go if you hadn't done that.
No. Well, I suppose maybe, I don't know. Suppose it's a combination of I'm not afraid of, you know, being stabbed in the back because I know how to handle it. You know, if it does come across, it usually ends with the other person, or the person who's doing the betraying, getting their head bashed in. Maybe a bit of that. But I guess, you know, I'm feeling a bit lost at the moment. And, you know, I guess I didn't want someone else to feel lost, if I could help it.
A smile spreads over Rowan's face and she's like, well, it does feel a little better to be lost together.
Emeth kind of like blushes a bit and then just quickly gets rid of it. And they're like, yeah, don't fucking tell anyone I said that though. Yeah, I will bash your head in if you do anything to them, alright?
I swear on my shield, I will not let anybody know about this.
Yeah, that that shield better be worth a lot.
Can both of you make perception checks, please?
Oh no!
Oh boy.
I'm so shit. Oh, a 16! Oh no. 16's so bad.
Emma. As you're walking, you swear you see a shape, like, trailing you, somewhat, like, at a distance. You turn around and you see something dart into an alley, but you're not sure. Could have been something.
What's wrong?
I swore I saw something move back there. Just in that alleyway over there.
Would you like me to take a look?
Part of me saying, oh no, it's nothing, Emeth, it's nothing. Then the other half says, we could be at a disadvantage if we don't see what that was. Could be someone who's going to report that we're here.
I would say that being careful is the best way to go right now. And I would like to head towards the alleyway that Emeth pointed me to.
Cool.
I'll follow.
You guys head down the alleyway. Make perception checks, both of you, as you reach the alley.
I would like to have my hand on my sword hilt.
Sure.
Nine!
You Seven. Both move towards the alley and look down. You see a couple of trash cans. That's about it.
May I just kind of walk over and kick him a little bit?
Kick a trash can?
Yes.
Sure, you go over, you kick it, it falls over, it makes a big clanging sound.
Yeah, there's no person in there. Whatever it was, it seems to be gone.
Well, in that case, we should probably get back there even faster.
Yeah, let's leg it.
Come on. Yeah, brisk power walk at the least.
Power walking is far more efficient anyway.
It's alright. I prefer a light jog, but whatever, let's go.
You both power walk back towards Emmett's house. Lucy, Dante, what were you guys doing whilst the others were away?
How long have they been gone for?
About 30 minutes.
How far is the city from us?
Like the main portion of the city?
Yeah.
Probably about 30, 40 minutes. 30, 40 minutes to the center of the city, and then probably like an hour and a half to the other end.
Gotcha. Dante, now that they're gone, is there anything you want to do?
Not really anything in specific. I'm just a bit worried of you know, if they get back when we're out or something. So maybe it's best to wait. Unless of course you have other ideas.
Yeah, you know me very well, don't you? What's around?
Please don't get arrested.
What's around this area?
Yes, near the Delnoa household. The Kindle household now, sorry.
Yes. It is mostly suburban. There's not a lot of, like, main area. The main, like, central business district is, like, around the center of the town. And then you have, like, the educationist district up near the university. So there's not a ton around. There's just other houses and small businesses, that kind of thing. It isn't particularly built up around this pot.
Would there be a mail center nearby?
Sure.
So Dante, I just need to write a few letters to some people back in Markovia. You want to tag along? Keep me out of trouble.
It's probably safest if we stick together. Yeah.
Right. Then we will head off to the mail center.
Oh, Matif will tag along as well. I'm not leaving him. You guys head towards the local post office, which is the state-owned Diplomatica styled post office. The colors of the post office are purple, yellow, and white, with a little cartoon image of Sir Robert the Bold, kind of like with a thumbs up. You head inside, and there's plenty of writing utensils and paper to begin writing letters.
So the first letter, I will add 50 gold to it as well. The first letter will be to Anishka, asking her how the orphanage is doing, seeing if it's all right, and here's some gold for the kids, you know.
Cool.
So that's 50 gold for the first letter. For the second letter that I write, and I write it towards little orphan Jeff.
Ah, yes, Jeff.
Ask him.
Young
ask him
Jeffrey Bezos, yes. I remember Jeff.
Yes. I ask him how he's doing, how my publishing is going. And in the letter, I also give him one platinum.
Oh, yep. It's like giving a 16-year-old, like, $1,000. Sure, yeah.
And then he writes a letter to his mom as well, gives her 2 platinum.
Okay.
Just letting her know that he's doing all right, but he can't really talk to her at the moment.
Okay.
And then one last one to Mr. Honzo.
Mm-hmm.
Also another platinum, letting him know that keep in touch and his services might be required soon.
Okay.
And that's all. That's all.
Your letters. Can you link me to that Google Drive, please? I need to check. Before you leave the old post office. Not necessarily these ones, the ones you've written pre.
Okay.
I'll try and zoom back and try and find them.
You're going to have to give me a second to find them.
That's fine. Give me back. It shouldn't take me too much time.
Dante, you want to write a letter to anyone?
I don't really have anyone to write anything to, so I think it's fine.
No one back in Markovia? What about, what was her name? Martha, the one who gave you the potato that you've been carrying around.
I do have friends and family, but I think they know I'm doing my best, and to be perfectly honest, I don't think they'd believe any of this. And I wouldn't want them to get worried.
Don't think they would have heard of you by now, considering all the things we've been through.
Oh. And like, Dante's face gets a little bit serious, like, oh no.
Sorry, go ahead.
I might have to explain some things if they know. Do you really think they know?
I don't know to tell you the truth, but you know, if they're worried, or even if they don't know, it's still worth letting them know that you're still around, still thinking of them?
That does make sense. I'd want more time to write a letter, so I'll start thinking of it on the road. Thank you for making me think of this. It seems important.
Yeah. By the way, did I ever tell you that, you know, for all of this, I was a farmer too?
No, I don't think you did. Where was it?
Yeah, I used to work on the fields in Cope Park. You know, just a young man working on his family's land. You know, planting cotton, watering them, protecting them from storms and pestilence. Where are you from?
I was a potato farmer up in Kartoffel. We're practically neighbors.
Ah. We never by chance met each other, did we?
I think I'd recognize you, Lucy. I mostly remember the halflings of the area, and I think humans were either recognizable or perhaps too armored to really see.
Well, I'll have you know that I've actually been a farmer longer than I've been a soldier, and even much longer than I've been a fighter. It's a much different life.
It certainly is safer.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot changed after I joined the military.
Do you also sometimes miss the fields?
Yeah, well, as you know, farming and gardening requires a gentle hand, you know. But then once I joined the military, let's just say that gentle hands won't get you very far. And especially when I met her, you know, when I met her, all I wanted to do was, you know, be strong. Strong enough to protect everyone, strong enough to protect her. But maybe you can tell by now that the price of power is very steep for people who are weak. And at that point, I think he looks at his hands. They're steel, you know. Very strong, very durable, but very cold and without feeling. That was what I exchanged for strength. No. It was a different time, Dante. It's like a memory that seems so far away. You know, the feeling of the soil falling through my fingers. The warmth of people's skin. It's disappearing. It's fleeting like a dream.
Well, yeah, in a way, through our journeys, we are both we both seem to be moving in different directions in relation to the fields we used to work. With your arms of metal and mine, sort of looks down at the bark on his hands, like also thinking that he is not quite as fleshy as he used to be. We're not the same people anymore. No, we very much aren't. But it's not like the fields discriminate. We can always change if that's what we need.
Boy, I hope you're right. So we check up on them.
You know what? That's probably a good idea. Yes.
All right. You guys leave the post office and head back to the Kendall household. Both of you make perception checks, please.
We're all gonna die.
I rolled a 14.
I rolled a 10.
You guys are fine, don't worry about it. So. You guys.
Definitely not worrying about it.
I don't know what you mean. You guys head back to the Kendall household. By sheer luck, arrive at the same time as Emmeth and Rowan.
Oh.
Oh. You guys, sorry. Ladies first, please.
Where were you?
Oh. No, I looked at Dante. Just at the mayor's office. Not causing any trouble.
Well. Dante sort of just nods.
Well, you're lucky. Nothing happened to you. Besides the point, we have a way out. Ship that's heading in the direction that we're also wanting to head. We'll be ready within the hour. So.
Can we trust them?
I mean, no. Of course not. But who can we?
Very true. We didn't have much time to look around your place, but is there anything specific that we should be looking for? Maybe food? I don't know if your ma keeps weapons around.
Let's just say her bedroom was quite interesting, if you want to even call it that. I haven't had a look at it before. I don't think so. I can't remember, Millen. I've already grabbed the box that has all that evidence you did in it.
I believe so.
Yeah, I would have chucked it like in the bag of holding or something. Other than, well, you know, all that. And some other stuff I found. Oh, I might go and actually steal a couple of her jackets or something.
As you say that, you hear a loud explosion from the second story of your house. You see the glass burst open and flames begin licking out the sides. See smoke begin to billow from the windows. What would you guys like to do?
Wait, are we outside?
Yeah, you guys are outside.
Oh.
Oh my god.
Roll to panic.
That's a shirt now.
Roll to panic. Okay, wait. Emote ideas. Roll to panic. What are you guys doing?
Well, damn, what the hell was that? And then Lucy looks around to see if everyone looks all right.
I have raised my shield, kind of trying to fend off any debris that might be falling off. Is that... That is... What? Do you have bombs in your house?
I don't know. Do I?
You're pretty sure your mom wouldn't keep bombs in the house.
No.
But she was also a demon, so who knows?
No. She was too smart. Then again, I don't know the woman at all.
I would like to run in just to check if there's any people in there, possibly.
Oh.
Sure. You head inside, you run in. At this point, you can see that flames are beginning to slowly catch on the walls and are beginning to slowly make their way downstairs. As you enter, you see a halfling man in a black... in black robes, completely hidden from view, with a small satchel on his hip. See him look at you, and I need you to roll initiative.
We follow
no!
her.
He followed all of you.
Yeah.
No, I meant, did we follow Rowan going into the house?
Rowan.
I was going to say that I did.
Rowan has just entered. You guys are just behind.
Yeah, I'd probably, like, yell out to her, like, Rowan, like, you know, Rowan, and go after her and be like, don't fucking just run into a burning building.
So we're all rolling initiative.
Yeah, everyone rolling initiative.
Oh, no!
Or Nor.
I got a natural one, oh my god.
And we have got a natural 20.
A duality.
Give me just a second. I need to quickly make a map.
What the fuck is going on? My house!
See, here's the thing about being an improv DM. I don't really know when battles happen, so it's hard to prep battle maps, because I'm like, I don't know what's going on most of the time.
Oh, no.
Or Nor, Eva.
Eva.
That's an Australian joke no one's gonna get.
Sorry, no.
Well, actually, I can use the map I was using before. I'll just use a portion of it. Alright, that's fine. I'll just move you to this bench. It'll do. It'll be jank, but it'll work.
Jank is the best.
Okay, let me just rework everything. So imagine this here is the door. This is supposed to be a dungeon, but it's fine. I'm not going to reveal it to the viewers just yet, because I do have secrets. Amesh isn't there either.
No!
Thank God. Ever battle map?
What was that?
Is this the first ever battle map?
No, but it's very similar.
I was going to say, it looks a lot like it.
Oh, actually, it might be.
Yeah, we
be,
had a room
no,
very
it,
much like this.
No, it's the same one, just turned a different direction. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, this is exactly where we're standing, is where everyone, mostly everyone, died to a fireball.
Yay!
Okay, so let's just... Alright, let me reveal stuff down here. So, this will be the... I need to reveal, not hide. But imagine this is outside. Oh, God. Everything is not working. So this is outside. Grease has just gone inside. Here is the dude up the staircase. Okay.
Oh no.
So initiative order. Up first we have Dante.
Yeah. Dante with a 20.
Yeah.
Natural 20 from Dante. Next, we have, we'll have Emeth go first, just because she has the higher initiative. Mm-hmm. Then it'll be...
Bitch.
Rowan. And, I need a roll for my team. Natural one. Okay, cool. Dante, you're up.
Yeah.
Rowan has just entered the burning building.
I cannot move my character.
Oh. Should be able to. Ah, then, damn it. I thought I fixed this, but I'll just quickly reset everything. Okay, Yume's works. Astrid's doesn't work. Sorry about the scuff, everybody. Welcome to VTT. Yuriza's works. Alright, everybody should be able to move their characters, correct? Yes?
Yes.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Alright, Dante. You're up.
If I go here, can I then still see the bad guy?
Yes, you can.
Okay. I'll just yell out, what are you doing? And then I'll shoot him.
Go for it. I'll just fucking murk him.
Shoot him?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, a 19 will definitely hit.
Yeah, what about 14?
Oh, right, because you can shoot it two times.
Because I shoot twice.
A 14 does not hit.
Okay. Wait, so it's 9 damage.
He is going to use his reaction. Of cantrip reversal.
Oh.
To fling that back at you.
Tasty.
You really came ready this time.
so you take 9 points of force damage. Dante.
I would like to take that damage.
Oh, yes, you can do that.
Divine Allegiance.
You can, yes. Sure. you take 9 points of damage, round. So you watch as Dante, you fling 2 Eldritch Blasts at this halfling. He pulls a Ace of Spades from his packet, from his pouch on his side. And the Eldritch Blast kind of like hooks around him in an arc and then flings back at you. But you see Rowan just leans in. Catches it on the shield, although a lot of the energy is dispersed up into her face. The Eldritch Blast smells of potatoes, Rowan.
Yum.
Okay, is that the end of your turn, Dante?
Yeah.
Just realized I need to pull up fucking this spell sheet. Spell thief page. Spell thief. Sweet. Emeth. Why did I put all the character names except for Emeth. I just put Astrid.
What have you done?
Emeth, you're up.
I'll walk in.
Okay.
He
You see the bad boy. If I just zoom real far in.
Gonna try and switch it to the combat screen.
Yeah, I'm gonna switch to battle screen. Oh boy. Eh. Okay, let me just get rid of. Sorry, my god, so much scuff.
Scuffer!
Scuffer Chan.
Scuffer!
That one, and then we'll go. Unlock. There we are. Alright, that should be fine. That fixes it. So
I move to there.
Cool.
I see this bitch. Actually, no, I go here. I see this bitch. I go. This is my. What the fuck have you done to my house, you bastard? And I'll shoot him.
Go for it.
Catch out! No! It's a lot.
You take out your pistol and you shoot it, and he kind of just leans out of the way, and it pings into the stone brick wall behind him.
Come on, wait. 5, 10, 25, 30. Where's the top of this, like the start of the stairs? Is this the bottom of the stairs, or is this the bottom of the stairs?
Let's say it goes in two directions. It continues going up.
It's like a two-way staircase.
Yeah, your mom was bougie. She has a two-way staircase.
Okay. Wait. Okay, I'll use the rest of my movement to get closer.
Okay.
I want to use no. No, I will use my bonus action to dash, but just to get to him.
Okay.
And then I will use my where is it? I'm gonna use action surge.
Go for it.
Just and then attack him with my rapier.
Mm-hmm.
Oh dear, this could be big mistake. Oh good. It could be good things. Come on. 17? Okay.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Oh no. Okay. 11 damage, because the sneak attack comes in as well?
Yeah, sneak attack does come in because you're attacking by yourself, because swashbucklers needed to be more overpowered.
Yeah, exactly. slash him!
You slash him across the chest, you see some blood go flying into the wall next to him. He looks up at you, he pulls down his hood, and he just flips you the bird.
Ugh. Distasteful. I throw it back at him. Another bird.
Okay, is that the end of your turn?
Yeah.
Hroen, it is your turn.
Mm-hmm. I wanted to ask about movement. Does diagonal movement count as 5 feet? Or...
Sure does.
Nice! Okay.
I'm just gonna... Wait, I'm just gonna go to the toilet quickly just so you know where I'm going.
I would like to use command... on him and tell him stay where you are, and I would like to use the halt command. My saving DC is 13. He has to
the wisdom
make a yes wisdom saving throw of 13.
Okay, that is a 4.
Yay!
He fails.
and then I would like to...
Takes no actions, okay.
And I would like to pull the hood off his head.
That is upstairs, so you will... You'll have to go either up here.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Here.
Yep, perfect.
Okay. Or actually, I would like to tell him to grovel so he has to lie down. No, actually, it's fine. He just doesn't do any actions. Halt is fine. Halt is fine right now.
Okay. Okay.
And I would like to see who the hell this is who just set my new friend's house on fire.
Right, you pull down his hood. Appears to be a halfling man with this greasy, like, greyish brown hair. Wearing black cloak. Doesn't seem to be particularly descript. He doesn't have any interesting facial features. He just seems to be a pretty normal looking guy.
Perfectly for blending into a crowd. Does anybody have a rope?
Does anyone have a rope?
I do not have a rope. I have a lute.
Take the strings off.
I think I have rope. I do actually have rope.
Huh. Nice. A am I still able to hold this dude down or something?
Action to cast a spell, so...
It is.
Yes, you won't be able to do anything like
that. All right.
Okay. So, is that the end of your turn, Rowan?
Yes.
Okay. He doesn't move, and he takes no actions. Lucy, it's your turn.
Okay. So, walk inside. Oh, let me get the move. Walk inside, and I want to, I don't know what kind of check it would be, but I want to see if the building is looking secure enough to fight in here for more than a minute.
Make,
if it looks like it's going to crumble.
Make an architecture check. Make a... My gosh, what would this be? Make an investigation check. That's the closest one. Or perception. Investigation or perception.
That is a 12.
Well, it's on fire, but the walls are brick. But, however, the floor above is wood. So, the floor above you might collapse, but you don't think the building is going to collapse. You just think the flooring of the upper two floors may collapse down. But the entire building isn't going to go, like, isn't going to fall over or anything.
Well, I just yell out, can't stay here for long. We need to get out quick. So I yell that out. And I notice that the man himself can't move. But I don't think Lucy really understands why he's not moving.
Mm-hmm.
But he's going to go as far as he can. And then he's going to cast... combat inspiration on Rowan, and he says, let's see what you got.
Okay, so you have an inspiration dice, Rowan.
Ooh.
D6, and because of Lucy's specific bardic inspiration, you can use it for, you can add it to ability checks, saving throws, or attack rolls, and you can also add it to damage.
Wow! Okay, 1d6.
Yes, 1d6.
Alright. Thank you!
And then, see, I can't really make it to him since the stairs are kinda... will I be able to go up the stairs, or is it too crowded?
The stairs are a bit crowded.
Well, I'll just wait down here and then my turn.
Okay. Matif is going to come next. He's going to cast... Just need to pull his feet up real quick. He is going to cast... Spark Bolt towards the dude. That is probably not going to hit. It's 15, which does hit, actually. It's a plus 8. Shoot, D's. I forgot how powerful this cantrip is. D's Louise. 17 points of damage.
Oh my god.
I don't know where I put my pen. There it is. And then he's going to use a sorcerer point to do Spark Bolt again. Using quickened spell. That'll do it. It's like a 17 to hit. Jesus Christ, that's 13 points of damage. Cool. Sweet. That's the end of Matif's turn. Back up to the top. Dante, you're up. At the top of the round, you guys hear a big crack come from upstairs. as if a large piece of wood is snapping.
Shit.
Dante is probably like looking around to sort of seeing if there's any danger around him, first of all. And he'll like yell out to the group. We should probably get out of here real soon, everyone. And I don't really want to shoot any magic up because it does look pretty crowded up there. And I think Dante assumes the situation's under control up there.
Sure.
So I'll really just take a step to the side.
Okay. Is that the end of your turn?
Yep.
Alright. Emmeth, you're up.
That is me.
That is you.
I kind of look up, real worried, frantically. And then kind of like, you know, like when you kind of bounce on your feet in hesitation of like which way you're going to kind of go. Kind of do that. And I will then just like stare this guy in the eye. Try to stab him again.
Okay. E.
No.
He's going to use fortuitous dodge. Going to use... This is the first time I actually get to show off spell things. He's going to use 3 karma points to... When a melee attack is made against you, you can cast Misty Step as a reaction. You do still get to get your... You'll get to have your attack, though. Go for it.
Oh, okay. 18.
Yes, that definitely hits.
Do I get sneak attack?
Yeah.
Because Roland's with me. Yeah.
She's with you.
16.
16 points of damage. Oof. This guy is not looking healthy. Nope, I can't do maths. It's not that much. Jeez Louise. Okay. And then he is going to appear. In the doorway. What else would you like to do on your turn, Emma?
Again, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. No, I can't. Okay. I suppose I'll use a free action. No, I won't. Oh, Lucy's still in there. He'll be fine, right? No, they're all still in there. Fuck. I'm assuming we're all running out of here. No. Are we all running out of here? Do we all, like, meta agree that we're all getting out of here?
Meta pigeon?
Yeah, brr. Are we all running out of here? Was that the plan? Brr.
Brr. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Brr. I was thinking of lying in the burning building.
Get a 10. What the fuck? Get a 10? Holy shit. Okay, in that case, I'll use a free action to flip him off. This guy. The guy. I'll flip him off. And then use my bonus action to dash and get right out of the house.
Okay, you will take an attack of opportunity from him.
Fuck it! I flipped him off, I'm fine!
Natural 1.
Get shit on him!
Cool.
I'm done.
Wait, you run out onto the street.
And then...
Okay, now it's his turn.
Oh, no.
Is it his turn?
No, it is Rowan's turn.
Okay.
Thank you for reminding me. I looked at the list and I just, my eyes skipped over Rowan for some reason.
Oh, yeah. That is fine. I would like to turn around a little, frustrated at this, sneaky little boy. And I would like to cast compelled duel on him.
Okay.
And say, fight me, you coward! And run up to him. He has to, what does he have to do? Wisdom saving throw of 13 again.
Okay. 14.
Damn it! All right.
He flips you the bird.
Is that all we're doing here? Just being disrespectful?
Yeah. Being incredibly rude, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, I can get until here at least.
Okay.
So he at least gets a bonk from me if he runs.
That is true. okay. Now it's the spell thief's turn. he is going to... couple things he can do. He is going to bring out his short sword, and he's going to make an attack against you, Rowan. And he is going to use... I have to do this before the hit. I'm going to expend his last three karma points to do double or nothing. Upon hitting a creature, I can spend... Upon hitting a creature. So I get to roll first. That is... Roll again, because that was a shit roll. He has lucky. I'm not just rolling again because it was a bad roll.
That's I did still not like hit. That, so I rolled again.
That was a 90. Still misses. Okay, so he's not going to double or nothing. Shit. What can he do? What's he got left? I created this class. I should know what it does.
Yeah, Mel, what are you doing?
He's going to use Ego Shield. You see a sickly green mist begin to begin to come out from his body as if there's some sort of like smoke from a volcano. Like it slowly begins to excrete from him. You can see from his skin just this low layer of sickly green mist. And that's gonna be his turn.
Do we get to know what that does? Or
nope.
Do we get to figure it out?
You get to figure it out. And then he's gonna try and run away, even though I think Ron's gonna hit him anyway.
Yeah, I bonk him.
Go for it. Go bonk him.
I bonk. There we go. Oh, please. 19?
Oh, yeah, that's...
Let's go with this. Oh my god. That is 6 damage and
6 radiant. So 12 damage total.
All right. Awesome.
Yeah, he's down.
Oh, shit. Could I have made my attack non-lethal by...
Yeah, you can make your attack non-lethal if you'd like.
Okay.
You take the flat edge of your sword and you just bonk him on the head. And he goes down. He's sleeping.
Peace.
He's sleep. Okay, we're still in initiative. Lucy.
As I see him go down, I would like to take another look around the room, not for the fire, but to see if there's anyone else suspicious around.
Make a perception check.
Either inside or outside.
Make a perception check.
That is a 16.
You're fairly confident there's no one else inside the house. From outside, you hear, stop! You have violated the law. On the flanking of heavy chainmail and plate mail coming from around the corner.
Great. I love that sound. So the man's already down. Sorry, did someone say something?
No, no, sorry. I was just oh-boying.
So not knowing if this thing's going to fall on him, Lucy's going to cast a false life on himself.
Okay.
And he gets a total of 5 temporary hit points.
5 temporary hit points.
And then, I will use my bonus action to activate the Sword of the Storm.
Okay.
And then I will, move here. And then I will just wait.
Okay.
By the man.
Matisse's turn, he's gonna begin running out. Run down there. At the top of the round, you guys, everyone hears it, but Dante and Rowan, you hear a heavy crack from the floor above, and it begins to tumble down. I need both of you to make dexterity saving throws, please.
Oh no.
Oh no. 8.
4.
Oh, oh boy.
We are so dexterous.
Oh, sorry. I rolled that in the wrong tab.
Okay.
Okay.
You just admitted it was a 4.
It's fine. It was a 4. I mean... Reverse lying.
You can also use the inspiration. If that's
I can! I would love to use the inspiration die.
Go for it. Extra d6.
Damn it. 6.
Still fail.
Yeah.
Okay. So the two of you take full damage. You take 8 points of bludgeoning damage.
Oh.
And 8 points of fire damage.
I have resistance to that.
So you
so
take
I can
4
take
points
4?
Of fire damage. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm also resistant to fire.
Oh, you are. So you both take 4 points of fire damage.
Oh my god.
Is Dante resistant to bludgeoning as well?
No, only slashing and piercing.
Okay. Ouch.
Yeah, just walk out of the burning building and
stuff. You are both also prone.
Oh.
No.
And you are stuck beneath a burning pile of
houses. Oh, shit.
I'm gonna use the web now because I can't find another appropriate one. Okay. Back to the top. Dante, you're up.
I'm going to cast Misty Step.
Okay.
To teleport myself, like, right next to myself, but not stuck under anything.
So into the same space, just standing up.
Well,
sure.
Yeah.
I'll allow it. That's cool.
My god.
Like, I don't have to fight with any rubble or anything. I just...
Yep. You just... Yeet. Up.
Yeah. And if I can, I'd like to try and help Rowan get free.
Okay, that's your bonus action. Make an athletics check. Dante is famously good at these.
Oh, yes.
It's okay, I have a good, a strong core. I can.
Rowan, you have advantage on your athletics check to become unstuck from the rubble.
Yay!
Hell yeah.
Okay, next we have Emeth. Emeth.
Oops, sorry. Never mind. I accidentally clicked.
Emmett, you're on the outside of the building. You hear the floor collapse on the inside, and you hear the muffled yells of pain from Rowan and Dante, and you also hear, "Halt! You have violated the law!" coming from around the corner as a bunch of guards start approaching.
Oh no.
Is Oblivion canon in my universe?
I'm gonna come here. I'm pick up the little man if I can.
Okay. He's not hard to pick up. Yes, you can.
Okay, cool. Like, swing him over my shoulder and shit. And yell, like, you know, to the inside. You guys okay? We gotta get out of here. And hopefully hope for a response. Oh, maybe, like, peek inside. Like, we're on top of him as well, because I'm kind of carrying him as well. Can I see them from here?
Make a perception check, because there's ash and smoke everywhere.
And a five.
As you try to peer in, you get a waft of ash into your eyes.
Yeah. Doesn't change the fact that I'll still yell out, "We have to get out of here, guys. Otherwise we're fucked."
I want to ask a gameplay question. I'm sorry.
Sure.
I just wonder, are we allowed to call back to these questions, or is it better if
So how I rule it is, on your turn, you have 10 words mm-hmm. that you can use to say things. If you talk too much, then I'll rule it and say you can't talk anymore. But as long as you keep the call and responses pretty short, then I'll allow it. That's fine.
Gotcha. On our turns, we can respond.
You can respond when they say it. It's just keep that in mind for when your turn comes, so you're not, like, saying too much.
Okay, gotcha. Then you just hear a muffled, "Okay, we're on our way."
I'll say, I'll just also quickly shout, like, "Meet at the docks."
Gotcha.
And then I'll use all the movement I have, plus a bonus action to dash to just get.
So that will give you regular movement.
Oh, true.
Because you're carrying a little man. So you're moving at half pace right now.
Okay. Wait, so then. 5, 10, 15.
I'll get you to here. Can you still see your piece in the darkness?
No. I'm view though. I can see that.
I'll just reveal it.
I can see that. Oh, does it really matter?
Doesn't really matter anymore. I'll take us from the battle screen, actually. Doesn't really matter what's on the battle map anymore.
Yeah.
Okay, so you begin to hightail it. I'm guessing in the direction away from the guards?
Yeah, away from the guards towards the dock is what's in my brain.
Okay, sure.
I hope that's correct. The docks are in the opposite direction, I imagine.
It's fine, we'll get to that. You begin running in the direction of the dock.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hopefully with Lucy, as if this is all happening in tandem.
Yep. Rowan, your turn.
I wonder, how do I roll with advantage for...
You can just roll twice.
Alright, I'll do that. I've been trying to figure that out. Okay, either 18 or...
Ooh, nice.
18.
Dante begins to move some, like, burning pieces of wood from your back, but you just completely, like, Hulk smash out, wave your arms up, just debris goes flying. Dante, you have, like, a small piece of wood smack you in the face. And Rowan just beast modes her way out of this pile of rubble. It's... Rowan, you've bench pressed more. That's nothing. You just completely beast mode your way out of that, and you're free. Easy peasy. Not even a question. I don't know why I made you roll. There you go.
I turn over to Dante. Thank you so much for helping me out of there. And I just kind of hold my shield over us in case something falls on our heads. And I hope we can, like, just run out.
Yep, that's fine. All right. Now that you're free, we're somewhat out of initiative. So you all can make your way out of the house and onto the street.
How far away are these guards to us?
Make a perception check.
Okay. Perception check. That is a 14.
They're around the corner, but they're probably about 50 feet away.
Okay. And can I cast Minor Illusion to make it seem like Lucy is still in the building? Not moving, obviously, because they can't do that, but...
Okay, sure.
Yeah.
It'll be... So kinda it's in like a 5-foot cube, so it'd be a short Lucy, but sure.
Can we do it so where he's, like, on the ground? And sure. Like curled up, kind of.
Yeah,
so he
easy.
Can fit inside that. Okay.
Cool.
And then I'll go ahead.
No, I was just finishing my sentence. All
right. Yeah, and then I'll go ahead and see if everyone's okay to start running.
You peek in, you just see Rowan beast mode way out, and they prepare to as they're preparing to run out.
And so I'll wait for everyone to start running out, and then I'll follow in the back.
You cast the Minor Illusion, and the three of you begin catch up to Emeth. Matif as well is following close behind. Make a stealth check, all of you.
Oh no.
Yeah, you make yourself disadvantage, Rowan, because you're wearing plate mail.
Do I have a disadvantage? Because I'm... holding the guy, or I'm just that good?
Yeah, make him, yeah. Disadvantage. You still have a plus 10, though. But, like...
Come on!
Oh, that would have been fucking great!
Yeah, all of you are fine. Oh my god, that's pro rolls.
I could have gotten... Oh my god!
That still evens out, but, like, that's insane. My lord.
Jeez.
Crazy.
Oh my god, wait, 2 nat 20s?
2 natural 20s, an unnatural 20.
Fucking hell. And an unnatural. Oh my goodness.
Like cats in the night, you stalk through the streets of Liu Pai towards the docks. Emeth, it looks pretty suspicious that you're carrying a man. You just take off your cloak and swaddle him like a baby and carry him.
Nice.
I consider doing the same with Dante, but I decide against it.
You all make your way through the streets quickly, quietly, inconspicuously towards the docks, where your new friend Leaf is, you know, milling about with his crew, waiting for you to show up.
Hey, Leaf.
Oh, yeah, hello.
We need to go now.
Yeah, not a problem. He just begins to, like, untie the ropes. He tells his crew, oh, yeah, it's time to get going. Goodbye. Liu Pai. And he begins to, like, kiss, like, blow kisses towards the city.
Big question. What kind of ship is this?
It's a, like, Viking longship looking, kind of looking boat.
Give me for not being familiar with Viking longships, but does it have any type of weapons or anything on it?
It doesn't appear to have any... what it lacks in defenses, it has in speed.
Mm.
It's a very quick vessel, and you can tell as soon as you make your way out of the harbor and they begin to push off the... Ship begins moving very quickly. He has about 10 crew members other than him who all begin rowing in unison. They lower the sail and you actually lurch as the boat begins to pick up speed.
Are they shantying?
They are sea shantying, yes.
Oh, God.
They are singing in Elvish. So, who understands Elvish?
I do.
I believe does Mateef right now.
Mateef as well does. Actually, he might not.
Oh, no, he knows Sylvan.
No, he knows Sylvan. He doesn't know Elvish. Yeah. He's an elf who doesn't know Elvish.
Oh, no.
They begin basically singing the Elvish version of Can't Fight This Feeling by REO Speedwagon.
What the fuck?
And all begin to sail into the early afternoon, leaving Liu Pai. You guys can see like smoke from the city behind you as Emeth, your childhood home, burns to the ground. Symbolically, perhaps?
Yeah. I'll sing along as well if I know the song.
You would know, you would definitely know I Can't Fight This Feeling.
A classic.
an Elvish classic.
Yeah, don't know what told it to me, I'm gonna assume.
Yeah, so where are we going?
Where are we? Oh, I just know that I want to head to where am I headed?
Pintika. You guys didn't really talk about where you you don't really know where Pintika is. Not on any map you have?
Really?
I don't believe so.
Do I recognize it?
Pintika?
Mm-hmm.
The name? I'll make a history check.
Yes.
I'll also ask Leaf.
Yeah, I've never heard of that name in my life.
Seven.
Seven. Pintika? Never heard of her.
Who's Pintika?
Yeah, who is she? Yeah, who is she? That is an interesting name.
Oh my god, who is she?
Oh my god.
I will say, I have so much fun doing the German accent. It's so... I love it so much. It's... I'm sorry to everyone listening, but I'm having so much fun. Oh my lord.
I try so hard not to just start laughing out loud.
Please do. I practice hard at this voice, okay?
Please do it. It boosts confidence.
Boost my confidence.
Boost it.
Push it real good.
So, where are you guys going?
So...
Yeah, we really need to stop off at some point, but, that depends on you guys.
Yeah, well... what about you guys? Where were you needing to go?
So, I myself might need to make a stop at Joran, but it's not a priority for me.
Don't we
There's
have to
more present that we need to attend to then. I'm all for it.
I was going to say, don't we have to find the last instrument?
So I asked Leaf.
Yeah, hello.
Leaf, how long will it take to get to Hashtag?
Yeah, it would take us about a week and a half. But we will have to make a pit stop at Jiwanaga.
Well, is that where you guys wanted to head down?
Don't know geography. Where is...
Look at the map. Oh my god, yes, it is very House of Holbein. Oh my god. Is that where I've got it? Oh my lord. I've been listening...
Holbein, yeah.
I've been listening to Too Much Six. That's what I've been doing.
Oh yeah.
Great musical if no one's listened to it before. Great musical.
Dude, fucking shit.
But it sounds awesome.
It's about the six wives of Henry VIII.
Huh.
Yeah, and there's a song about his German wife, which is number three or four. And she's from the House of Holbein. Like a German royal family house. Ah. Yeah.
Did you put the map in world info?
Sure.
It's only got the real old one.
Where are we dropping, boys? World info. There you are. You may need to download the image.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry, for my butchering of your accent. I apologize.
Oh no.
I'm a simple Australian.
I really don't think she minds. I think she's having a blast right now.
We just left the Diplomatica.
This is how the world sees your country. Sorry.
It's an upgrade.
Oh my god. So, okay.
Okay, so
the stop off?
So, okay,
can you bring the map up on stream? Do we have a map?
I can do some quick magic.
Just because I'm really visual and I suck ass and I'm
sure,
still
I'll just chuck it up like
out
this.
Where we're going.
Okay. So there we are. It's covering Dante, but that's fine. Windy does barely talks. Alright. Yeah. So here is the map.
We're just leaving Liupai.
Yes, you guys are leaving Liupai, which is at the top of the Diplomatica. I'm just gonna make this map bigger. Cover everybody.
Yeah.
So you guys are at Liupai, which is the top of the Diplomatica. You will be heading westwards and then south to Jiwanaga, heading along the coast of the Nagocracy, so the Prismatic Isles. You're going to be heading along that coastline.
Okay.
Down towards Kaidosi, stopping off at Nirt, and then up towards Hallstatt.
Okay.
So a little
U-shape, almost.
Yes. He explains while it would be quicker to go past Pogbal and Pillager's Cove, it's fraught with pirates and dwarf cultists. So, generally speaking, not a great time.
What's the capital of Shogak?
That would be Adafidels.
I was gonna say, where all the kingdom shit is.
That would be Adafidels, yeah.
Well, that perfectly works out for me, then. Yeah, because I wanna... Once we get to Hallstatt, I want to go to the capital, thing as it's in Schoberg.
Leif, how much faster would it be if we took the more dangerous route?
We could make the trip in maybe... Wait, I need to get back to voice. Oh yeah, hello. Okay.
Vintan Vosla.
It would take me maybe 5 days.
That's much faster.
Y'all think we could fight off some pirates?
Oh yeah, if you think you have the means, we could give it a go. But if I sustain any injury or my ship is destroyed, I will bill you the cost.
We have two pirates on our ship, so...
That's no worries. That sounds like good fun.
It sounds rather dangerous.
Well, Dante, you can probably blow up any ship we see with your Eldritch Blast.
An absolute killing machine, Dante.
Aw, he is?
He is. He really is. He looks so small and, well, like Dante. But... No, he is a cold-blooded fucking murderer sometimes. It's crazy. You should see it.
I can hear you, you know?
Yes, I know that. Yes, I know. I don't think he means to, but... Yeah, he's powerful as fuck. Kinds of nuts. So yeah, as long as we got Dante, we'll be fine. Aside from me, of course. Yeah. But yeah, I'm happy to make that cut. Are you suggesting to go... The 5-day journey would be to cut through above Pogbal and below the Pillager's Cove?
Yeah. And...
It's a straight line as opposed to a weird U-shape of sorts.
Yeah. And maybe experience what being a pirate is like. Maybe get a little bit of booty.
Mm-hmm.
That sounds like a good time. And, you know, what's a journey without risks? I feel like we've done pretty good so far.
Yeah, so what do the rest of y'all say?
Yeah.
Well, whatever you decide, I will do my best to protect you.
Nice. Dante? Do you have anywhere you want to be?
Well, I'd like to eventually, you know, I have some business over in Schoberg, but I mean, I'd like to go there safely.
I'm sure we'll be fine.
Well, if you say so, I guess it's probably best.
Yes. Yeah, so, Leaf, if it is all right with you, we'd like to take the quicker route.
Yeah, not a problem. Punch it, boys! And all of the guys begin rowing in unison.
Oh my god.
And, Leaf, can I... Actually, let me ask the party first. Is it all right with you guys if we make a stop by the Pillager's Cove?
What for?
I have some business that I'd like to hire. Some mercenaries.
Hire?
Yes.
That sounds illegal. Let's do it.
Oh my god. That yeah. That sounds illegal. Let's do it. Another shirt. Alongside Roll for Panic. Beautiful.
All right. Well, Leaf, is it all right with you if we stop by the Pillager's Cove?
Yeah, it would not be my favorite place in the world. But, he begins to mull it over. Make a persuasion check.
We'll pay extra if you'd like.
Make a persuasion check with advantage.
Please let me do this one. No, actually, don't.
Oh, you want to do it? Sorry.
Oh, just because I do have a plus 10 to persuasion. Holy shit, never mind. I just saw. You have a plus 10 as well? I didn't know that.
Yeah,
oh, never mind. No. Ignore me.
Yeah,
sorry,
buds,
I'm sorry.
Buds get.
Shit.
Buds
get
expertise as well.
Oh my god. Never mind. I'm so sorry. Please, you roll with advantage. I'm so sorry.
Sorry.
No, I was just gonna say, so what do you think, Leaf? Sound good to you?
You know, usually I do not like to go this way, but for extra gold, I will do it. I do not like the Pillager's Cove. It smells of vodka. But we must all get over it one day. Huzzah!
Oh my god. Well, I guess we should Oh no, sorry, you go.
Sorry. If someone has something important still to do, I don't have to.
No.
Go ahead.
I just wanna talk to Lee.
Yeah. You just wanna hear me talk more. Sure, I'm game. Hear me.
She walks out with Salif. Where are you from?
Yeah, you know, I grew up in Hallstatt, but I have traveled all over the world, you know? Been to many exotic places.
Like what?
Oh, you know, he pulls out his map. You know, the craziest place I've been is this, place called Joful. It's in the Deadlands. It's very crazy.
Oh, does that ring a bell with me by any chance?
Make a history check.
13.
A memory begins to surface, but then bubbles back down.
I see. Suddenly hearing... I suddenly seem to have lost any inclination to jest. And I... I let Leaf finish and then I leave him alone.
Yeah, you know, it was crazy. I drank so much beer. It was very fun. Yeah, they have this celebration. It's called Septemberfest. It's very fun.
So, considering all we had to get to know each other so fast. While waiting, why don't we play a game? If you guys are down.
Oh, here we go.
Game?
Rowan, you should enjoy this, I think.
Okay, I'm excited.
He just does this sometimes. Just bear with it.
How about you, Leaf? Would you like to participate?
No, I am very busy with my crew right now. Maybe later.
All right. Well, okay. I don't know if y'all have heard of this game.
I've broken Eureza.
Oh my god. You're so sad that you weren't doing the game.
I tried.
There's heartbreak.
Yeah, so, the game's called Two Truths and a Lie. Not sure if y'all have heard of it before. But essentially, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say no, I haven't.
Oh, yeah. Well, we just share two truths about ourselves and obviously a lie. And the rest of us have to determine which one is a lie.
I find that idea very, very fun. I would love to play it. I know nothing about my past. I do not know if we'll get a lot out of me, but...
Well, it doesn't have to be anything about your past.
All right.
It could be maybe, like, favorite food. Whatever you know about yourself.
Gotcha. I think this is a great game. Let's play it.
Dante, are you going to play?
I can do that.
Alright, then who would like to go first? Or shall we roll for it?
Oh, someone got some dice in their pockets.
Leaf, you got any dice?
Oh yeah, here you go. It is a D20.
Fuck.
Alright, guess the lowest goes first.
Sounds good.
Lucy rolled a 15.
Damn it.
Oh. A 10.
Well,
I rolled a 5.
Please regale us with your truths and lies.
Okay, give me 1 second to think of something.
Sure.
Okay. Oh no. Do we have several goes at this? Or
we'll keep it to one go.
All right, gotcha.
Because last time this happened, there was like 3 rounds in it. So one round.
Gotcha. Okay. I Oh no. Ah. Sorry. I'm having a brain fart.
Yeah. Maybe Dante should go first. If you're having a hard time remembering stuff.
Sorry about this. No, no, I can do it. I can do it. I can make anybody tell me the truth. Love sleeping without a pillow. And I really like getting drunk.
Ooh. This is a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Does she look like the type of person to get drunk to you, y'all?
Oh.
I look at Rowan's face, and I look straight over to Emma's face.
Oh, no, no, no. I know a drinker when I see one. She drinks. She definitely drinks. What was the other one about a pillow?
Yeah, I like to sleep without a pillow. Completely straight, like a vampire, with my arms crossed over my chest.
Oh, okay, so that is a lot different than what you originally said about just without a pillow. No, that is completely different. Just fucking arms crossed over. Oh my. And what was the first one? I've already forgotten.
You can make anyone tell me the truth.
Oh, I believe that. You're lying about the pillow. Vampire bullshit.
I agree as well. She looks like she can take down maybe like a dozen or so drinks.
Ooh. Dante, what do you think? What do you think she's lying about?
I'm personally quite fond of pillows. I don't quite know about the rest, but sleeping without a pillow seems kind of weird.
I love Dawn.
So what is it, Rowan? What's the lie?
Never had alcohol before.
Oh, you've got to be... You are fucking with me. You've got to be fucking kidding me.
I have been sleeping excellently yesterday, just completely straight.
You sleep on your back straight, no pillow, arms crossed over like a fucking vampire. Are you kidding?
Yes. I wished my bed had been harder, honestly.
What? Why? For
I like
what?
The feeling.
You like the feeling. Okay.
Leaf, my friend, do you have any alcohol on this ship?
Yeah, please.
You hop on a ship with a bunch of sailors and you ask, do we have alcohol?
Yeah, Lucy, dumb fucking question.
He walks over to like a... he walks over to a safe. Wine or whiskey?
Both, thanks.
He throws you two, a bottle of wine and a bottle of whiskey. Very cheap wine and whiskey, but wine and whiskey.
I'll grab one bottle of it. I'm gonna guess if it's corked for aesthetic, I'll like... pull it out with my teeth and like spit it out and shit and then just kind of take a swig and then hold it out to Rowan. This may not be the best first drinking experience. However, no first drinking experience is good. So, drink up if you'd like.
I take the bottle. Well, this seems to be quite the nice experience. Can I just check in with myself and my oath, if this is okay?
Sure, go for it.
Do
I roll for something, or...?
Let me read your oath real quick.
Mm-hmm. Law, loyalty, courage, responsibility.
Okay, wait. Well, it wouldn't be responsible to get drunk, but mm-hmm. wouldn't hurt to drink a little bit, necessarily.
Wouldn't hurt. Take a little sip to drink responsibly.
Yeah, drink responsibly.
There we go.
Yes, you don't need to be honorable and responsible right now. We've done all that work. You deserve to try.
Well, responsibility is a lifestyle, not a choice.
Technically, it just says you must deal with the consequences of your action. So you don't necessarily have to be responsible. You just have to deal with the consequences.
I am fully prepared to face the consequences of this, and I take a gulp.
I just want someone to fucking quote that before she goes nuts.
All right, Rowan begins drinking.
What's drinking?
You begin drinking.
Oh.
See, she's already drunk.
What's that ringing noise?
It's in my head. Oh god, it's already begun. When will you learn? When will you learn? She's have consequences! Keep Victoria for reminding me of that meme, fuck! Oh my god! Ooh, sorry. Anyways, we're playing two truths and a lie now, aren't we?
Yeah. Dante, it's your turn.
Go on.
Yes. So... I am... 23 years old. I've never worked in a field that didn't have potatoes. And I used to live in the same town as Lucy. And I just sort of give a bit of a look at Lucy, but try to be like sneaky about it.
Oh my god.
Make a stealth check,
Dante.
Make an insight check at everyone else. Except for Rowan, because she's drinking.
That's a natural 20.
He's 100% not lying.
Yeah, okay. Ooh, I wonder. I'm going to guess that you're not 23, but you're probably like 1 year off. You know, nothing drastic, but enough to try and throw us off. Maybe 24. I don't think it's the age.
Well, Dante.
Hey, Rowan's did it.
Oh, yeah.
I guess.
Sorry
about that.
You
were just so caught up in the wine that I wasn't sure.
Yeah. I stare at Dante intensely, like the bomb still in my fist. I find the notion there's so many fields. How do you, thinking you've only worked in a field that grows potatoes, is so crazy, it has to be true. So I'll go with the age as well.
Well,
Lucy won't answer just because.
I did not grow up in the same town that Lucy did. We're close, but different.
Huh. Well, what a shame. I thought you were childhood friends or something.
That would have been so sweet, wouldn't it?
It would have been.
Oh, I know.
I do think Dante... Lucy is way older than Dante, I think.
I think they were only like 3 years apart.
Oh, really? I thought Lucy was older. In my mind, Lucy's like 30.
Yeah, Lucy is older than Dante, but not by that much.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, look who's next.
Oh dear. Now I could be existential about it, or I could be fun about it. Because I'm not sure what's true about me anymore. This will be extra hard for Rowan, all of these, I feel, because she doesn't really know us as much. Don't have that too many, you know, contextual clues.
God, Astrid's thinking real hard about this. Ooh. It's so good in theory, but it's so hard to think.
Just thinking Lucy will take a swig of the whiskey.
It's a good idea. I just remembered we dragged that other guy on board and he's knocked out. We'll get to that, I guess.
Shit!
Yeah, I was holding him.
Maybe just sitting on him now or something.
Okay, just using it as like a
yeah,
stool.
Yeah. I'll probably be sitting on him. That's funny. Oh God, what do I? I don't know what I. Well, I don't know what's true, what's a lie. Yeah, I don't know. My beverage of choice is rum. I sleep only in my underwear and nothing else. I'm in the midst of an existential crisis. Kind of cheating, so, but
definitely know. The second one's got to be a lie.
Mm-hmm. You seem like a person who sleeps naked.
Exactly.
Oh no, you got me. Yes. Yes. Why the fuck would I wear anything to bed? God. Come on, we can agree that. Right. No? Yeah. Does no one else? Is it just me?
I'm pretty sure I slept in my armory yesterday.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
I'm just imagining Rowan just lying, just like a vampire in full plate mail.
Fucking hell no.
No pillow. Just sleeping.
That is, oh. So
wishing for a harder bed.
Yeah, the jail cell is probably like a 5-star hotel for her.
It was quite comfy, honestly. There was a reason why she was knocked out for so long.
Oh my god. No, so it was just me then. No, not even you, Lizzie.
Sometimes, but it's not my preference.
Oh, we can change that. It's your turn.
All right, we'll skip over that. Well, let's see. He takes another swig of whiskey. I'd really like to see if you guys could figure this out. But Dante, you are not allowed to answer.
Okay.
So the first one, I used to be a cotton farmer. Number two, I lost my right arm to an accidental explosion. And number three, I've only ever been with one partner. What do y'all think?
Merlin, does his arm, or just Yume, I guess, anyone, does the right arm where it stops, does it look, what does the scarring look like? Does it look like it was a clean kind of chop, or did it look like it was kind of like
from his original cut arm?
Yeah, because this was his right arm.
It is jagged, rough. It's been chopped off.
Chopped off.
Or like,
I'm saying like,
it has,
like, would I be able to tell kind of the nature of how the arm came off?
Yeah, not like, cleanly.
Okay, good, cool. That's what I needed.
forget that we've seen each other naked, pretty much.
Oh yeah, no, the last one's definitely a fucking lie, come on.
I would say, remembering him mentioning yesterday how much he sacrificed and holding out his arms, I say the second one is a lie, I think.
So you think that Em, you think the lie is the explosion, and Rowan, you think the lie is the cotton farmer?
Oh!
Is that right?
No.
Or are you saying the arm as well?
Sorry, I say the arm.
Okay. Well, I'm actually kind of curious. Can you use that truth thing you were talking about on me?
Yes, I can. I would like to cast Zone of Truth on the ship. Wait, one second. I only have one. Oh no, I have two. I have two spells left. How long does it last?
Time of day is it, Merlin?
At this point, it's late afternoon.
Mm. Yeah, so it's late afternoon, so...
I would like to cast Zone of Truth on this ship.
Okay.
On the ship?
Yeah, it's like...
How big is the range? Gosh.
Oh no, it's just a 15 feet area. I don't know how big
it is. That takes up most of the boat. Not all of it, but a fair chunk of it.
Oh wow. God damn.
Okay, now you guys can choose to fail your check. If you'd like. Otherwise, you can make a charisma saving throw.
I will choose to fail it. Does Leaf... What is Leaf roll?
You want to know?
Fucking two.
Can I just call over to Leaf? What is your darkest secret?
Oh my god.
Oh yes, you know, my darkest secret lives deep down within me. I'm not truly from Kingdom of Schoberg. I'm actually from Liu Pai. That is my deepest, darkest secret.
It's not even the same accent, holy shit!
Yes, it is all an accent. It is all an act. It is a fake accent. I am sorry to deceive you all, but this is my true accent.
I look deeply heartbroken. I regret everything.
Oh my god, fuck no! This went so wrong!
My day is ruined, and I am going to go cry now. And he turns around. He walks to the other end of the ship.
Oh. Where's Leaf from, actually?
He's from the Upai.
Oh my god. And he said he was from Schoberg.
No, he wasn't from the Kingdom of Schoberg. He's actually from Liu Pai.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He says he was not from Schoberg. Oh. Imagine if Leaf was my fucking dad. Sorry, that'd be hilarious. That'd be so funny. Just because the accent was more posh, I'm like,
You could ask him, though.
No, absolutely not.
Now's the time.
Are you afraid to find out he's actually your dad?
You know what? Shut the fuck up.
Oh yes, a random sailor man I introduced in a random episode. It's Emmett's dad.
Yeah, who has definitely he's confirmed he's not even from Schoberg. Anyways, wait, Lucy was gonna you were gonna say something?
Yeah. So how does this work? Do I just say stuff?
You just say it.
You can't deliberately lie.
And well, you can't lie unless you try really hard.
So you guys are right. The lie is that I lost my arm to an accident explosion. That was the lie.
What? Sorry.
No, you go.
Can I make an insight check on Emmett?
Go for it.
Uh, 15. Is she good?
Emma, with a 15, are you good?
Emma is initially very fucking surprised. Like, are you serious right now? Very surprised, but kinda not sad, but like you know, kind of assuming that Eve might have probably been that one person, and that's all he's stuck to, and it's kinda like, you know, she's not here anymore, and I don't know, she's thinking. She's thinking a lot. Yeah. And tries to cover it up, kinda, to everyone else with kinda like, oh, like, you know, no way, you're too hot for only, you probably have a whole list, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, well, as you know, I can't lie anymore. That's the truth. Just one person.
Was it her? Was her name Eve?
It was. It was.
No.
So who is Eve? I say carefully. Not sure how I should read the room right now.
Like, can't lie, so. Yeah, Eve was the, I believe I met her when I was about maybe the first year of the army. So maybe my late teens or early 20s. Met her under a tree. I was walking past and she was reading a book. The title was Flowers of Evil, if I remember correctly. Wasn't long after that, I was smitten for her and she taught me poetry. I was never much of a reader before until I met her.
Hey, Rowan. Make a history check.
What? Please. 17.
As he's describing this memory, it seems familiar.
Eh? What?
Nani kore?
Oh no.
Just seems familiar, like a story you've heard before.
Huh, okay. Okay. I seem confused for a second. So this Eve? Who is she? Like, do you want to tell me more about her? I do not want to pry. I just feel like I'm recognizing something.
Yeah, sure. I feel like I've told the rest of the group, so I don't see why you should be any different. So let's just say I've been looking for her, and coincidentally that's how I ended up finding you in jail, actually. But
oh.
Yeah, the last I ever saw of her wasn't actually really her. It was more just what was left of her. The story goes that you fell in love on opposite sides of the war, and we tried to run away, asking the help of one of my friends, but he eventually betrayed us, and here I am.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, well, we just do what we gotta do, I guess.
And is she still out there?
I assume so. I've been looking for her. Without really any luck. but I would like to see her again if I can and apologize.
Apologize?
Can I make another... can I attempt to lie on this one?
Make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh my god,
charisma?
Oh, sorry, charisma. Yeah, charisma saving throw. Sorry. Thank you. 16, yeah, you save, so you can now knowingly lie. But, Rowan, you now know that he is no longer under the influence of the spell.
Yeah.
Sorry, Rowan, what was your question again?
What you would apologize for.
Oh, yeah. Well, there was, like, something that I was going to say to her before we stopped seeing each other, but I can't really remember what it was at the moment.
I nod understandingly, actually feeling really bad that the zone is still working. I'm a little lost for words, I suppose.
Can I have some of that wine that you have in Rowan?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
I hand it over to
you. I was going to say.
You guys drink, pass the time eventually before finding your way to sleep. There is a... Oh, sorry.
Oh, yes. you go, Risa.
I just wanted to ask, as long as the Stone of Truth is active, if we want to interrogate the guy you're sitting on, Em.
Oh!
Yeah, he's waking up now.
Hey, wake up. I kick him with my heel.
Shit, wait, I'm trying to remember what accents halflings have. Shit. They're Spanish, right?
Oh!
Shit. Oh, yeah. God, I've got to go to that after doing...
Hey,
for so long.
My stuff.
Hey man, what the fuck am I doing on this boat, man?
I grab him like by the collar. No.
Oh, you're that crazy bitch.
Oh yes, it is me, that crazy bitch.
Oh yeah, you're really good at fighting, man.
Oh, thank you. Gosh, I haven't heard that little compliment before. Alright, now tell me, what the fuck were you doing?
No, I can't really.
Yeah, he needs to roll the save. you know that he is not under the effect of your spell, Rowan.
Gotcha.
Yeah, man, I just can't seem to remember. No, maybe I was hanging out. Maybe not. You won't get it out of me though.
Punch him in the face.
Make an unarmed strike attack.
Is he down to like 0 or 1?
He's on 1.
Oh.
It's fine. I have
actually, even if she punches him, it's 0 damage because she has a negative strength.
I can lay on hands and bring him back every time you punch him to death.
Oh yes, that'd be wonderful. See, we can keep doing this all day, all night.
Hey, we man. Can just
getting
I've
closer
had,
and closer
I've
to
had
death.
I've had bitches than you try to get some secrets out of me.
Sorry, what was that?
I've had some tougher bitches than you do trying to get secrets out of me.
No, sorry, I can't hear you from all the bullshit you're spewing out.
Can I use thaumaturgy to make her eyes burn?
Sure.
Name one tougher bitch.
He seems unfazed.
Damn it!
Oh, you know, like the Emerald Queen?
Who? Sorry, have never heard of her before.
You know, Xandros, he's pretty scary, man.
Okay, I will have to say I have heard of that one before, but still, come on.
But, you know...
Who do you fucking work for, alright?
What's everybody's passive perception?
14.
9.
Yeah. He goes, hey man, I won't tell you that secret. And he pulls out a hourglass, tips it upside down, and you see his body almost disintegrate to sand and blow into the wind.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
You watch the sand, and it travels in an almost perfect path that you guys have just sailed in the direction towards Liupai.
Mm.
Is this hourglass still there?
No, it disappears with him.
Gotta be fucking kidding
Can
me.
I cast command on the waft of sand?
Sure. That's a fail, yeah.
I would like to command him to grovel.
You can command him to growl.
Not growl.
No, no, no.
I want to pour it down into the water.
He made a pun. He said gravel.
Oh.
Oh. Oh, sorry.
Rawr.
Okay, so how that'll work, because he's technically sand right now, is that when he reaches his destination, he will then grovel.
Damn it!
Okay. It won't force the sand
to grovel for.
That's just
like
sorry.
A minute. So when he reaches his destination, he'll just be on the ground for a minute.
That is just. That's just funny. That's just. Oh my god.
I think I have cursed this man. Oopsie.
Sorry.
I wanted to stop him.
You right. Guys didn't search his pockets. You guys didn't do anything.
Fuck. Lizzie, pass me that bottle, please.
Sorry.
I give her the bottle.
Thanks. Start to just scull it. Out of, like, anger and frustration.
On that note, as you guys head down for the night, and find solace in drink, all of you finding some sort of bed space in between the rowing benches, is there anything you guys would like to do before bed?
I think I would like to chat with Lucy, I think.
Sure.
Where would Lucy be hanging out?
Probably sitting near the edge of the boat, just looking out to the sea before he goes to sleep.
Mm. I'll come over and sit down next to him. Hey.
Hey. Hey, how's it? How's it going?
Well, as good as you can be, I suppose, when, you know, everything's happening so fast. You lose your arm, you lose your hair, you lose your... Well, family? Well, I didn't really lose family, though. Seems like I might have lost a lot a long time before now.
Yeah. Sorry all that happened to you. Definitely a lot.
Yeah, don't apologize, though. You didn't do anything, really?
Yeah, well, sometimes I don't really know what to say in these situations.
No, me neither. Which is perfect. Neither of us know what to say.
Do we have to say anything?
I mean, I suppose not, but... I mean, one thing... I don't know, it's been on my mind. Since that fight with Del Noah. She's still in my head. I think, at least. Bitch, are you still there? I, like, kind of call out to her in my head.
Who are you calling out to?
Don't know. I gotta not call her my mom because she's fucking not my mom. Do I get anything?
You get no response.
Well, whatever, she's still kind of connected to me, which, you know, isn't preferable. But she's not gone, and no, she knows that, you know, that I, you know, want to protect you to an extent, I guess. But I was, you know, I also want to protect everyone else and stuff, but just, you're, you know, a target now, even more so in her eyes, I suppose. What is this? You know? What are we? No. But yeah, like that, but like not really. You know, I don't know what we are, but I just feel like, you know, you'd be in danger if she knows that I care about you, and I don't want you getting hurt. Does that make sense?
Well, let me just tell you, I'm always in danger. In fact, I probably am danger itself. So, if that's something that worries you, I don't think it really needs to. But to answer your question, you want to know what this is. Is that right?
I guess, you know, I'm not really, you know, one for labels and such, but I don't know, I guess maybe just I haven't been getting any answers, so, and everything's been a bit of a blur with no definition and no confirmation for anything, so, I don't know, maybe some clarity would help. You know, in my life at the moment.
And Lucy thinks to himself, so here's the thing, Em. I ain't afraid of much, but there's one thing that I am afraid of. It's kind of like you losing someone I care about. But as you also know, even if I am afraid, I wouldn't let it hold me back. So and I think from there he'll recite a poem.
Classic Lucy moment.
Yeah.
I do have a question before you say your poem. How many backup poems do you have?
That's a great question. Holy shit.
Maybe like 10 poems.
Oh my god.
Damn.
Bruh.
Oh, hold on. Let me just get out my giant folder. With my all my poems in there, and just flick to the most appropriate one.
I've been waiting for a kiss this entire time.
recite a poem for you. You know what? This is fine.
So he's going to put his hand on your cheek, and then he'll get in kind of close and say, "The seduction of you, where would I begin? A brush of your cheek, or a hand near your chin? A set of smoldering eyes, or a devilish grin? You ain't asking why, just a matter of when. I ain't no angel, baby, I'm a dealer of sin. But I can touch your soul deep from within." And then he'll give him a kiss.
Yeah, no, Emmett's gonna just fucking snug the shit out of him.
Okay.
Yeah, and kinda, yeah, snug him, stand up, look at him, keep staring at him for a little longer, and then go off to her quarters.
There are no quarters, you just find an empty rowing bench and just lay in between them.
Yeah, and I'll just kind of sit there, kind of like, yeah, yeah, I was looking at you for like, you know, if you want to, that's fine. If not, I'm just going to go and probably cry myself to sleep.
I'm next to you on the floor, my arms crossed over my chest.
Oh my god. Shit.
So, all of you head to bed. Some of you finding sleep, others not. The rocking of the boat is gentle. The waves aren't particularly intense now that you guys are on open water. Dante, as the ship drifts further and further west, you hear a voice. Quickly. And that's it. Rowan, as you find yourself to sleep, you know, positioned like a fucking maniac, arms crossed like a vampire, you find yourself to sleep. You get brief flashes of similar scenes: a dark pebbled beach, overcast sky, a woman in the distance that you can't seem to find the features of. And then suddenly your vision clears, and you are standing in a clearing in a forest. The grass is red around you, reds and oranges like autumn colors. There are white birch trees forming the edge of this clearing in the forest that's onward. You see a devil-like man in front of you, if you want to look at roll 20.
Oh.
A devil-like man in front of you with gray, ashen skin. Darker, even darker obsidian ram's horns that curl upwards. He's kind of in this kind of like boxing position. He's kind of like bouncing from foot to foot. You know, his hands are up. Like, come on, come at me. And that's where we're going to end tonight's session.
Oh.
What?
What?
Excuse me!
I'm famous for ending on cliffhangers because it's most fun to keep you guys excited for next session.
Oh my god.
God damn it!
I want to keep you guys invested, alright? I want to give you things to look forward to.
Oh my god!
Merlin, please. Sorry, Apollo. I'll show everybody on the battle. I'll show everybody the battle scene just so they're prepared for next week.
So pretty!
Oh, can I add flavor to the previous thing? Because I totally forgot to say something.
Sure.
That definitely when and pulled out of the kiss. She's probably crying.
Okay.
And is like, and then just, yeah, kind of walks off.
Sorry, I'm dying at what Apple said.
Oh my god. Oh, wait, Ethelo, bonk, horny jail. Holy shit.
No.
I condone this.
Yes. Join me in my horny jail.
So.
Horny nation, come on, baby. Let's go.
So, thank you for joining us, everybody, for episode 21 of Herald. We'll be back next week, same time, same place. And it's time for everybody's favorite time of the year. Time to #plug yourself. I got in before Windham. Holy shit. let's go in reverse order. Yuriza.
Hi, I'm Yuriza. I do art and gaming here on Twitch. And if you want to check it out, you can do that.
Amazing.
Thank you for watching today.
Everyone's favorite, definitely German, not Danish, VTuber, Windham. Have we lost Windy?
Windham!
Oh.
Have you been muted?
I was muted.
No!
You've lost nothing of content. Nothing good content, at least.
Oh no. Oh no.
Yeah. I'm Winton Mosler, detective VTuber and part-time catboy. Next week, I should hopefully be ready with a new model variation.
Ooh-woo.
That's going to be kind of nice. And I play a bunch of games, basically whatever I feel like. So anything's welcome. And I think that's about it for me.
Amazing. And just to answer Aflo's question, no, we are live next week. However, we will be having a 2-week break after that. Over the Christmas and New Year holiday. We will be back on, I believe, the 8th of January. Okay, next up, Arcana the Astrid.
Hey, yo, it's me, Astrid the Arcana. This was real cool. The big emotions were awesome. I had a really, really, really fun time. Once again, very happy that we have Yuriza here permanently as a new member of this chaotic bitch of a crew. But yeah, I'm Astrid. I stream here on Twitch. I play a bunch of video games. I also do art, which I mainly post on Twitter. I haven't been doing enough of it though. But yeah, I had fun. And I'm very grateful that everyone decided to come along and watch the chaos unfold.
Amazing. Yusubeni Yume.
Yes, well, I'm very grateful for the game as well. Grateful for this wonderful crew of ours. And then also very grateful for everyone who decided to come today. You can find my stuff on my YouTube channel under the same name. I will probably be posting the poem that I just recited. For M. And like I mentioned before, I am writing Lucy's origin stories. Still deciding on whether I should release it chapter by chapter or if I should wait.
No, chapter by chapter. You gotta keep the fans horny.
Okay. So then it would be figuring out where I should make it available in. Possibly. We'll see. But
okay.
Looking forward to next week and thank you.
Amazing. And I am your humble dungeon wizard, Merlin the Magister, man of a thousand voices, which all sound roughly the same. I stream Apex on my main Twitch channel, Merlin the Magister. So if you want to see the world's most mediocre Valkyrie get some kills, get some wins, feel free to chuck me a follow. Apart from that, I don't think we have any announcements. Guardians, our other D&D game, is live tomorrow at times I'm about to say, because I forget time zones are weird. 9 p.m. EST, 2 a.m. GMT, and 10 a.m. Australian Western Standard Time.
Things are starting to heat up. They encountered a moonstone dragon last week. Our wonderful cast are just finding their sea legs, and I'm finding new ways to DM because each group is different.
I thought you were going to say finding new ways to kill them.
Well, let's start with Dante first. Let's start with Dante. Although, I don't know, Eureza's going to give me a run for her money at the moment. Run for my money. 21 AC. Oof.
Even higher when we're next to her.
What?
That is true. Even higher if you guys are next to her, so.
What? Oh my god.
Technically, she can max out at 24.
Oh, come on. Okay.
I will be your shield!
She wasn't joking! Oh my god, you weren't joking! oh, shit.
Apart from that, we have our new emotes, so if you guys love our content, feel free to subscribe so you can get our juicy emotes. We have more incoming over time. I fucking love the radical, the Amesh radical one.
Me 10 minutes.
I will also be adding new emotes soon, because I'm getting some new PNG artwork done up, including, I'm going to love this one, Merlin the Frog, which is going to be Merlin in his regular outfit, but as Kermit, and maybe a couple of other outfits. I want to have like a Dungeon Master outfit, so I think we're going to have some stream rewards where you guys can redeem outfit changes for me. Apart from that, I think that's it from us. Any other announcements, everyone?
Not for me.
I have an announcement. I love y'all.
Hey.
Hey. It's adorable.
Hey, that's fucking adorable, man.
Hey, that's fucking adorable, man. Get that cutie pie shit out of here. Goddamn.
That is fucking rad, dude.
That's fucking rad, baby.
For our new viewers joining us, if you would like to catch up with the story of Herald so far, please head to our YouTube. I have a Nightbot YouTube link. I do not. Windham, can you drop the YouTube link, please?
The YouTube link.
Fastest linker in all the West.
I know, Windham is disgustingly quick at linking. So, there it
How
is.
How the fuck did you... Oh, okay.
There is, in fact, also a link in the About section.
There is.
Oh!
So if you would like to, if you would like to catch up with the story so far, go back, watch the VODs, episodes 16. Let me get it up real quick. Episode 16, onwards, is pretty essential if you want to catch up with the most recent story of Herald's. But if you would like to go back and watch from the beginning, where they're little baby adventurers going through, Markovia and the Arbor Republic. Feel free to go back and watch some of that. Other than that, we have been VTuber Tabletop, and we will see you on the other side. Goodbye.
Bye.
Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.